Texas could soon be liberated from cannabis prohibition, and psilocybin therapy might be coming to Maine. This is Loa Verihil keeping you up to date with the latest in cannabis news. Lawmakers in the state of Maine have introduced a bill that would legalize psilocybin therapy. What's remarkable about this bill is that there won't be a medical diagnosis requirement, and it would allow adults 21 years and up the ability to purchase and use psilocybin products under the supervision of a practitioner who specializes in this kind of therapy. This measure is designed to be similar to the one that passed in Oregon back in November. Maine's proposed bill includes a 15% tax on sales and would legalize manufacturing in a vertically integrated model and establish formal guidelines such as possession laws, product testing, and standards for providers. A separate bill has already been filed that decriminalizes all illicit drugs and instead reduces penalties to a civil fine that can be waived with a health assessment. With many states making efforts to reform their antiquated drug laws, we look forward to see what's happening in Maine. Next in news, a new House bill in Texas could expand the state's restrictive medical cannabis program to include more patients and raise the state's comically low THC limit. The measure would allow for more qualifying conditions such as cancer, all forms of PTSD, not just combat-related, chronic pain, and any debilitating conditions that severely impact one's quality of life. This would be a game changer for many Texans. This measure would seriously open up the entire market and allow for more patients the legal freedom to pursue alternative therapy. The bill has just recently passed the state House vote and now awaits the Senate to vote. Be sure to stay tuned because this would be monumental for the state of Texas. And lastly, higher education has taken on a whole new meaning for the state of New York. Since legalization, many state colleges and universities have added cannabis courses to help educate and prepare people for the state's new workforce that's projected to be a multi-million dollar industry by 2025. These courses aren't just meant to learn how to grow cannabis or to become a bud tender. Professionals in industry sectors such as healthcare, law, finance, science, and business are all encouraged to become educated as well. The landscape is certainly changing for cannabis, and it's reassuring to see states become determined to support a plant that has long been persecuted. With cannabis education becoming normalized, it won't be long until the stigma is finally broken. So go ahead and like this video and give us a follow at Verihil to stay up to date with the latest in cannabis news. Thanks for watching.